It is such a crazy life, this hockey life. But we are going to a different team. We are leaving Linköping tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. and we are going to, I don't even want to try to say it, but it's 4 hours from here. It's Gävle, Sweden, or Brunos. He's playing for a team, Brunos. I don't know how to pronounce anything right now. At least I had some time to practice my Linköping one. But we are packing up our apartment, which is really kind of sad because I really liked this apartment and I really liked Linköping. I really liked the city here, but where we're going, I heard, is really nice. So I'm gonna take you along for this new vlog, packing up our apartment in a day. And we're taking a road trip down there, so it's a 4-hour drive, which is really nice that we get to drive. I really like that because we have a lot of stuff and I didn't want to have to worry about my bags being overweight. So it's just weird. It's just so weird, like life and just this life and just going different places and like not being able to just kind of stay in one place because you never know what's gonna happen. And I look like a mess. I'm stressed out and breaking out, but our apartment is like, it feels so empty now. I mean, we took everything down pretty much and it's super messy over here. I'm gonna show you guys just how freaking messy it is. We're trying to get our life together right now, trying to get everything super organized. But like, I've never seen like our apartment just so empty. Cut me off there, but I'm back. But I just wanted to show you my bags and our bedroom's a mess, so please, no judging. So yeah, come along to this crazy, crazy, crazy life. We have our whole apartment packed up in the car. We are on the road, gonna be like 4-hour drive. Good times.
That I've never been, seeing things that I may never see again. I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road.
Morning from Gävle, Sweden. This is such a weird life and such a weird situation because we've been here for 3 days now and we've been in a hotel and like Ola is now on a road trip. So I'm here in this new city all by myself for the next 2 days, two, three days. And it's like, so what do I do? What do I do with my time? I don't know. I would love to get my nails done, but since we're in this hotel, it's not like I know where anything is, and I don't know how far any of the places are. So, and I'm really bad with directions. So like, even if I tried to go walk somewhere or tried to go somewhere, it just wouldn't work. I don't have a car because Ola took it to the rink. So yeah, it's a weird situation. And there's not much to do. And the gym here is not that nice because it's like a much older gym. And with COVID, I'm really timid and scared to kind of touch any of the equipment. So it's not like I'm going to the gym, but I've just been either walking on the treadmill or using my booty band, kind of. When I do use the weights, I'm like, grab one set of weights and I like really sanitize them and that's about it. So yeah, I don't know. And like, food is so tough because I'm typically like to cook my food at home because I'm a really picky eater. And so obviously in a hotel, there's no refrigerator here. There's no stoves, like there's no microwave. So it's not like I can make anything here. So I've been ordering out most of my meals and it's just been like total shit meals. Like, it's been McDonald's, it's been pizza, it's been sandwiches, Subway. So it's just, yeah, it's not great, and it's showing on my skin, it's showing everywhere. So I don't know, it's a little bit of a stressful thing, but so far, like, Ola is doing great on this team, and like, we're both really excited for him. It's just so crazy to like pick up your life and like in less than 24 hours like move it to a completely different city. So I wish that I had more footage, but like, honestly, there is nothing to show you. That's the problem. So as of right now, we haven't really done much because Ola's been working as soon as he's got here. So whenever he gets a few days off, I'll be able to kind of go around town and show you guys. And maybe today, while I'm here by myself for the next 2 days, I'll get some more footage of, I'm going to attempt to go outside, obviously, because I'm going to have to get myself food at some point. So I'll go outside and kind of show you around the area that we're here in the hotel. So yeah, that's really all. I look like trash, sorry. But that's really all I have to say right now. Crazy. I mean, the hotel is a mess right now because our suitcases are everywhere, but I guess this is the life of a professional hockey player. Just some people end up staying in one place for their whole career, and some players are just bouncing around. I'm in like a group chat for expat hockey wives, and for the most part, I've seen a lot of girls like where they've been in situations where they've been from place to place, or like that hotel living. And a lot of them say, like, at the end of their husband's season, like, they wouldn't have traded it for the world. Their experiences were amazing. And, you know, just in the moment, sometimes it's really stressful. But, like, overall, looking back, it's going to be the best years of your life. And I haven't had, like, any negative feelings about any of this. It's just, it's overwhelming sometimes. But for the most part, this has been, like, such an awesome experience for me. And I'm really thankful that I get to do this with my boyfriend. So the only stressful thing is being in a new city by yourself. So I don't know, hopefully I'll be able to figure it out, 'cause I'm a big girl. I can do this.